November the 4th, day before Election Day. I'm hoping that today is the last coat of primer before shooting color and clear coat on this car. I've had to go back and fix a few little places that showed up in the guide coat. And I broke through the primer in a few places. Little high spots. They got a skim coat of primer on them though, so I'm not worried about them. A little bit there, a little bit here. My mixing ratio is going to be 4:1 and 0.5 with the urethane primer. It's a urethane 2K primer. So that will be like a sealing primer, and I'm going to come back over that after I shoot that. That'll be the second coat. I'm going to shoot one coat on the trunk, one coat on all the places where I've broken through. Let that sit, flash off for 10, 15, maybe 20 minutes, and then come shoot the whole car down. And that'll be the second coat of urethane primer. And then come and wet sand that, probably with 600 grit, and then go with the clear. Or color in there. Wish me luck.
Yeah! It's done. Second coat.
All done, I think. I'm a pretty happy camper. The air setup that I'm using, I've got a window that I blocked off. It's all sealed off with foam rubber and everything. That's a 28 by 28 filter. Electrostatic air filter. It actually cleans the air quite well. I've got two baffles under the garage door made out of tube of fours covered with sheet cloth, plastic, stuff you put under your house for moisture barriers. And I've got this right here all the way across is foam rubber to seal that. I've got two box fans running. It actually pulls a pretty good little breeze across here. And they're all sealed in. And up at the top, where the garage door goes over, from the outside, I got up on the ladder and stuffed the gap there with foam rubber, just like this stuff right here. So, in theory, all or most of the air that comes through here, comes through that window, comes across the garage, across the car, and carries the mist outside. I dumped it on my truck that's parked right outside. Actually, I did move the truck. I just remembered. Let's walk around. There are the box fans. There are the baffles. And up there, foam rubber that's stuffed in that gap all the way across. There may still be a little bit of air to come through these cracks right here, but it won't be very much. There's a fair volume of air coming out of those guys. I mean, you can see, I don't know if you can see how these baffles are sucked in. Just trying to pull air through them and it can't get through. It's got to pull it through the window. So, I'm not unhappy. You can look through the window, see the car in there. I can go back inside, walk through. Wonder where Darwin is. He's usually out here with me. Yep, the smell is gone. So there's nothing but fresh air coming through. So I did remember this time to prime the fuel door. I had this thing hung up over here. Several times I've primed this car and I keep forgetting to hit it. And I made myself remember today. So, yay me. One thing I wanted to check on is the temperature in the garage right now. About 78 degrees. I started it with about 73. So I should have this in the window with 65 to 80 degree. I don't know if it's reducer or the activator. Boy, I'll tell you what, I messed up big time. I poured reducer in one of these cups. When I mixed it in the one of these guys to get the ratios right, and I had reducer left over. And I went to pour it back in the container, and I must have taken one extra dumbass pill this morning. I'm sorry. I opened that container of activator and poured the remaining reducer in it. So that's probably ruined now. Yay me.